Every year, thousands of students come to the University of Massachusetts Lowell in search of a brighter future. They bring with them their dreams, their ambitions, and their hopes for what lies ahead. But for eight young men who lived in Donahue Hall, room 104, what they found was something much more. They found brotherhood, they found courage, and they found the power to achieve the impossible. They fought an inevitable war between stagnicity and conforming to standards of society. This is the story of one legendary year. This is the story of Donahue Hall, room 104.
Living in Donahue has probably been the best year of my life. I've met a lot of great guys, created a lot of bonds that I'll have with me for the rest of my life. You know, we've experienced a lot together. We've been through a lot of ups and downs, but you know, overall it's been a great year. It's been a crazy year, you know. We're gonna remember these moments for the rest of our life.
You know, if I'm gonna be honest with you, it was over before it really began.
Okay, let me just think. The day was August 17th, 2022. I flew in, and we haven't looked back since.
Welcome to Donahue Room 104, the place where legends are made and where boys become men. And this is their story. Enter summer camp, a week-long camp in Lenox, Massachusetts, testing the limits and limitations of the group's physical abilities, but also being the true beginning to the bonding and the brotherhood that awaits.
Yeah. It goes in and out, rhythm from the speaker, play it out real loud, yeah. We go round and round, coming to the venue for the UK sound, yeah. Can the sun please shine, why? 'Cause it is our time now. This is my freedom. We unite as one. It goes in and out. Rhythm from the street. We unite as one. It goes in and out. Rhythm from the speaker, play it out real loud, yeah. We go round and round, coming to the venue for the UK sound, yeah. Can the sun please shine, why? 'Cause it is our time now. This is my freedom. We unite as one. It goes in and out. Big tune, play it out real loud.
Man, I go into the rave, man, I start a couple pounds. Everybody queuing up because they know it's going down. Man, I bubble like a MS-95. I won't let the system get up in this life of mine. It's getting intense in the campsite. The sun go low and the people go high. It goes in and out.
Camp was a great experience for me personally. I had a great time training with everybody and throughout, but I had this one issue where it had to whip it out.
After a week of strife and physical training, the summer camp had come to an end. But for the roommates at Donahue Hall, room 104, it was just the beginning. Michael Sosi, the last of the original roommates, had finally moved in.
Initially, when I moved in, I was pretty anxious on the first day, but very soon after coming here, I found I had good camaraderie with the guys and fit in quite well.
In the following months, the roommates had bonded and become closer, and finally they learned about the values of being non-stagnant, and more specifically, stick.
Stick! Stick, 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 stick for shooting and one is for fun. Niggas tripping off of 151. Black and miles burning under the sun. Black and brown kids, younger, they dumb. Sack of town, where your mama know from? Gather around, running all of your shit. Never put up on a yard and get struck. Everyone I grew around was a thug. Thought he was a shooter, thought he was tough. Found anybody cooling out in the shed. 14 county, 50 cal in the tub. Fuck around and shoot the cavalry up. Bullets sneezing, we got allergies. We got alibis, we got calibers. Categorized, FN, bitch, capitalized. Better recognize. I got sick and tired of letting bitches slide. So I'm in the whip, I got the stick inside. If I sniff a scent, smell a lie, smell a bitch, crack a smile, let it rip, let it ride. First time, second line. Second time, bloodline. Third time, even I die, taking one of mine. I'm on Keller Road with a chopper from Columbine. Creeping on the cracker, trying to colonize.
We've got out of this shit.
These four men living on one side of Donahue had sparked a new and innovative idea. They had decided to conjoin their individual dorm rooms and create a bedroom named the Quad, and the place of study and solace being. The office.
Ladies and gents, I just want to show y'all something. Whoa! This is retardation at its finest.
Fascination with the underwater world. It began with a simple bit of fish named Gooch Man, purchased at a local pet store. But soon, this single fish blossomed into a collection of different species and tanks. This is the story of the start and the unfortunate end of the fish era with only a few survivors.
Night for you?
Well, I don't remember much.
Alright, so check it out. You niggas over here talking about festivals. I'm thinking more like invasions. You gonna stop playing on Dreamville's time?
Yes!
Batman free!
Like niggas don't
run this!
Pray for me, guys gotta play for me. Me and Emma not standing adjacently. Thirsty for the clout, talking too brazenly. Bullet hit his mouth, at least he died tastefully. Good Lord has never forsaken me. In God I trust, so I get money faithfully, not just occasionally. Got to make cake every day like I work for a bakery. I know you pussy, the secret's not safe for me. You crazy, you think you gon' take from me. Not for extorting tree pilots like Ork. And I call up some niggas I know that's gon' spray for me. Speaking in cocaine, they taping me. Let out the whole fucking clip, leave a vacancy. I'm out that two with the six on basically. Repping more shooters than Rich Paul's agency. They get to clutching, you best get to ducking. Like 6-7 niggas that's dunking for Oregon. Money so long if I start in the south and then spread the shit out, they be touching like Portland. So it's no wonder I'm walking with caution. I know that guy got his grace for me.
Thank you, Justin.
Alright, Johnny, tell us how your first Thanksgiving was.
It was really good, you know. The food was absolutely awesome. It was great to meet Mike's friends as well, yeah. What made it even better was staying in the same house as his mother.
Sunday night be thumbing, thumbing, thumbing. Got these babies with an onion and she got her own money. She say money keep her coming, but I keep them commas coming.
After a brief Thanksgiving break, Donahue 104 had finally returned to one another.
They like who fuck broke the wind. Yeah, double up my cup. I sip lean, not gin. Yeah, I be high as fuck. They feel like my head spin. But no, I ain't standing. No telling these bitches. Hell nah, give me head. Keep your draws. Yeah, yeah, big dog. I don't know about y'all. Yeah, yeah, blink, plow. Jury came Niagara Falls. Yeah, yeah, stack it tall. Money in the flowing wall. Yeah, one to the two, to the three, and to the four. Big Glock is all about his motherfucking dope. Ready to make an entrance where my back end, bruh. Because you know I'm about to turn shit up. I told her throw that ass back so I can bust it like a bubble. South Memphis nigga in this bitch, yeah, you know you in trouble. Ain't nothing but a P-Thang, baby. Young iced out nigga going crazy. Paper route is the label that pays me. Unplayable, so please don't try to play me. Know what I'm saying? Yeah, bitch, I'm the man. Before you talk, raise up your hand. Yeah, I've been running up, you nigga just been running errands. How you screaming, creeping blood and ain't been to the land? What? Hold up, dog, pound, you some mutt, you need to scram. Yeah, you know how I get down, money talks, you hear me loud. Yeah, I know you hear me loud, I be counting like one, to the two, to the three, to the four. Big Glock is all about his motherfucking dope.
As the winter months settled in, the boys of Donahue Hall Room 104 had found themselves on the cusp of a new semester, filled with anticipation and excitement for the adventures that lay ahead. They had just returned from their first Christmas break together, their bonds stronger than ever before.
My name is
One, two, three, go!
Hey, 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 fill it up, fill it up. Hey, 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 fill it up, fill it up. Hey, 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 fill it up, fill it up. Hey, 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 fill it up, fill it up.
Let me get another cup, please. I ain't driving home, so you can have my keys. Got a bunch of tricks all hidden in my sleeve. So I'ma get drunk, I'll be leaving till three. Yeah, I got a reputation, I'm getting wasted. Everything in sight, homie, we ain't trying to save shit. Leave the spot dizzy, so now I can't see, bitch. Sexy bartenders always get a really mean tip.
Stop with
J Dubs, bro!
J Dubs!
Who's the hottest in the room?
I mean, Joey with that haircut, low-key hitting, but I gotta say it's you.
Who's that?
Michael Roberto. Hit my lineup.
It ain't me. It ain't me. I know what.
The group then planned their next endeavor, a ghost hunting expedition to a nearby haunted tunnel named the Clinton Tunnel, caught completely on footage.
I'm a millionaire, son.
was scary. Alright.
How you feeling?
I'm fucking
shit. How you feeling?
I'm fucking shit.
How you feeling?
Is it all over the story?
No, do not.
It
stinks. Stepped in some muggy ass water.
As the winter months came to a close, the boys of Donahue Hall Room 104 eagerly anticipated their upcoming spring break trip. They had planned an adventure like no other, a journey to the scenic lake house in Bristol, New Hampshire, then travelling north to St. Albans, Vermont.
That is crazy! That's crazy!
Yeah.
boys and me. A walking staggered vision blur. One thing you'll come to know, boys back home live for things like dead man's curve. I recall what he said, he'd rather be gone in death than living like those sad folks in town. I can't take this soul with me. If I go, I'm going quickly. Keep those heavy eyes free and proud. Oh, when I'm old, I will recall all the nights we spent outlaws. It's getting cold, that sun is crashing, and heavy eyes ain't long to rest in.
Nearing the end of the boys' spring break, they had encountered an epiphany that occurs once in a lifetime. Not a mere blink of vision, this was a dream. These young men would become not only simple musicians, but rock band legends. This, my friends, is the start of the rock band era.
Yeah.
Wait, we can't forget this.
I give that Greek sauce. Sex! Yes! Look at this nigga's face, bruh.
Who out of the 8 people in Donahue room 104 is the least intelligent?
Freddy.
Most likely to die first?
Freddy.
To get an STD?
Freddy.
Biggest dick?
Freddy.
Most likely to be gay?
Freddy.
Quit the team?
Freddy.
Get their dick sucked in a vending machine?
Johnny Stock.
Most likely to die a virgin?
Freddy.
Rich.
Susie.
Porno.
Ethan.
Terrorist.
SK Dubs.
Most likely to forget their uniform?
SK Dubs.
Smelliest.
SK Dubs.
Best hygiene?
Probably Ethan.
Most likely to do anal.
Susie.
So, as the coaches of the 8 boys of Donahue 104, what were the expectations that you had for them coming into this year?
Go for it.
You go first.
Expectations were they would pass all their classes, and they managed to do that for the most part, and contribute where they could on the team. And we've definitely had that. I think everybody on the team, everybody in that group has contributed in some way to the team.
I think the biggest thing is just fitting in with the culture that we've built. Obviously, the academic side kind of takes care of itself, but I think coming in and trying to work really hard and try to set up the building blocks for the future.
So how would you say these 8 boys have grown throughout the year? What growth have you seen within them?
Seen them grow as people and as athletes, and definitely we're looking forward to them taking the freshmen next year and the freshmen the year after under their wings and continuing hopefully the success that we've had up to this point.
I think they've really opened up in personalities throughout the year. Some people were a little more quiet in the beginning of the year, and some are now a little bit crazier than we probably thought originally. But I think they do have a lot more leadership qualities than we thought coming in, and they're ready to take on the reins a lot sooner than probably expected.
How would you say the freshmen of Donahue Room 104 have progressed throughout the year?
Yeah, I mean, it depends on the guy, you know, it depends on the guy you're asking about. Some have gone forward, some have gone backward. SK has become more of a primitive animal than he was when he came in. I would say most have progressed. You know, I do think the tasteful office was a big step forward for the freshman class. It's really kind of distinguished them from other freshman classes that have lived in Donahue 104. But, you know, they also had a couple more months in there than some other classes had in Donahue 104. So,
now, would you say that group of freshmen is stagnant?
You know, depends on which freshman from that group you're discussing, but potentially.
Interesting. Thank you, Billy.
So, Emma, what are your thoughts on the boys at Donahue Room 104?
Sure. So, when I first met you guys, I thought a lot of you were oddly quiet, and boy, have I learned that that was incorrect. You guys have some of the best personalities of residents that I've been with. You guys are willing to do your talks. You guys are willing to have, like, me come vamp with you guys. You guys have been pretty good. I've had no complaints. I've never had a concern about you guys. I've always reported good things. I've always enjoyed having you guys in prison.
Each one of these 8 boys have brought a different, you know, quality into my life that I wasn't used to before, you know? Like, SK bringing some sort of chaos. Freddy, you know, bringing unintelligence. Johnny bringing in an accent, you know, just all these different things.
Oh, Freddy, yikes. Yeah, Freddy's just this, now Freddy just, yeah, he likes to tell you, and sometimes he'll just tell you, and then just tell him Fred.
What about Josh Rivers?
He's not a part of the boys. He doesn't live there, I don't think, right? Does he not live there or no? No? Sean. Sean and Josh have an interesting relationship. I think it's more Sean pegs Josh versus MK pegs Josh.
What's your favorite moment from 104?
Them setting up the office.
Movie night.
Richard the Lobster being thrown in the river.
making a whole movie list and never watching any of them.
As our journey through the legendary year of Donahue or Room 104 comes to an end, we are left with a sense of awe and wonder at the incredible bond that was formed within those walls. We saw how a group of individuals, strangers to each other, came together to form a brotherhood that will last a lifetime. As we reflect on this remarkable year in the history of Donahue or Room 104, we are reminded of the power of human connection and the joy that can be found in the most unexpected of places. We bid farewell to Donahue or Room 104, but the memories and the brotherhood that were formed within those walls will live on forever.
5, 4, 3.
Donahue Hall, Room 104, rehearsal number one. I think it's time to have a discussion. This band thing, it's not working out. We're not playing good. I think something needs to change.
I agree. I can't be doing two things at once. We need someone new. We need a new singer.
Does anybody have any ideas?
We could put up a poster.
Yeah.
Have some tryouts.
Yeah.
I agree.
Let's do this.
Just playing, boys. Let's go. Let's go, boys. We got this. Let's go.
How's it going?
Hey! Shut the fuck up. Sit down now. And what the fuck do you want?
We want to go big in the music industry and we need your help.
Yeah, I've seen you guys perform, yeah. Got a lot of talent. I can make you guys a lot of money.
Let's make this shit happen.
Now get the fuck out!
Sir.
Let me be drunk! guitar! Oh, let that be rock!
Making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again.